We'll be back in a moment.
With me, an incredible athlete, Edwin Moses. Edwin, delighted to have you here, and I'm dying to hear the story about how anybody in this day and age can go 72 meets undefeated.
Well, it's been a long road. I've been going racing for 6 years now in the 400-meter hurdles, and I've really been trying to take each race individually instead of thinking in terms of breaking a record, the standing at 88, or winning 100 in a row, but really just trying to look at each race individually and attack it individually and plan on one race at a time.
And you're a little too far ahead of me, but we got a guy, Dr. Gideon Arrow, just chafing at the bit because he wants to show you the digitization. Remember, we were able to film you earlier this week, and so now you're going to get a chance to see it. Edwin, great having you with us.
Thank you very much, Vic.
Good to see it.
Okay.
Hi, Edwin. How are you?
All right.
Thank you for coming here.
Thank you.
Another superstar in future sport.
Edwin, the little dot here in the center of your body is the center of gravity. Most people, when they are running, they're landing with the center of gravity behind their foot, actually falling backward or stopping themselves. You have a fantastic technique where when you land after going over the hurdles, the center of gravity is in front of your foot, which means all your momentum is transferred to the body going forward. You're falling forward and continue to run. You don't lose any energy.
And that's the main problem in running 400 hurdles, keep from slowing up between the hurdles. Every time you slow down, then you have to use a lot more energy to speed up again.
We can look on it also in a continuous trace. Then we see the whole trace, and if you look on this blue dot in the middle, this is the central gravity. You see it's going up, it's going down. You can look on it also from the front, so we'll see you from the front, how you're doing it from the front.
The criteria here, Edwin, that you will not go over the hurdles too high. And as you see yourself, you stretch pretty good. You're going forward, you can see the little dot, the center of gravity, just going over the hurdles, but you are going to stretch it pretty good. It's important that you are not going to jump over the hurdles, but actually to stretch your body as much as possible. For that reason, let's look on the same motion from the top view, and we'll check how much you stretch over the hurdles. Now looking from the top view, we see you going toward the hurdles, and you have a tremendous stretch with your body. Tremendous stretch. This stretch allows the center of gravity to stay low and therefore save you time over the hurdles. Here you see the same thing in a multiple trace. Look on this stretch, Edwin. You have incredible stretch here, and this is fantastic technique.
Learn anything new, Edwin?
Yeah, I'm learning a lot here. It's the first time I've really been able to see myself in slow animated motion. Stick figures, first time for sure.
First time. Well, it might not be the last time. Edwin, thanks for being with us.
Thank you.
Super job.
All right.
Gideon, great job as usual.
Thank you. All right, thank you.
Coming up next, we'll take a close look at an aesthetic event as we meet Sharon Shapiro, 1980-1981 intercollegiate gymnastics champion.